We want to improve the survival for patients with advanced pancreatic cancer and then hopefully move that even earlier disease as methods are evolving to detect it earlier.
We have all embraced a common purpose, and that's really to bring new therapies into the arena of treating pancreatic cancer and to really extend, we really believe, significantly doubling the survival patients get with this really horrible disease. We wanted to understand what are the fuels that feed pancreatic cancer.
Our goal is to demonstrate that cutting off the fuel supply, much the way you take away the gasoline supply from a car, will render cancer ineffective and turn it into an illness that can be defeated.
So we've made some very good headroads in understanding how one profiles how a tumor eats, what its source of nutrients is, and how we might be able to intervene in that.
We got the clinical trials, all four PROMISE clinical trials, up and running.
With those four trials, we have the ability to test some new principles of pancreatic cancer. And one aspect of the metabolism we've been studying, we were very able to quickly roll in some new approaches to treating the inhibit autophagy right into the pancreatic cancer trial. So that's from idea to actually treating patients in a matter of months.
One of the most important things that we need for improving cancer therapy is a more rapid way to assess whether a treatment is working.
The imaging that we do by looking at nutrients really helps us determine by which patient benefits and which patient unfortunately doesn't benefit. We built an equivalent imaging agent, which requires adding a special isotope that can be safely imaged in the body to glutamine itself. And so that was the chemistry that was accomplished this year.
And that's what the second clinical trial has been all about, is put together a combination that allows the drugs that we do give to get to the cancer. I mean, the pancreas is deep, all the metastases are deep in the body, and without a sensitive way of measuring it, we were stuck. Now, with the new scans that Craig's developing, we have a way to follow the tumor. This tells us within weeks whether or not it's working. If it's not, we need to change. That, I believe, is a great sign of progress.
It will give tremendous new hope to patients with cancer as an approach to individualize their therapy and more rapidly get the benefits of the best possible treatment.
One of the really surprising and wonderful things about Stand Up to Cancer is how much collaboration is going on between the dream teams. The effort has really opened up five new approaches to how we think about cancer as a disease. There's an acceleration, there's hope that there'll be new therapies delivered for pancreatic cancer.
The clinical trials have been started. We have patients that are benefiting already with complete disappearance of their stage 4 pancreatic cancer. I don't think there's any question that patients are alive today because of the Stand Up to Cancer efforts.